Okay, so Apurva, one of the arguments that we tend to hear is that so a lot of the male actors, superstars, even they tend to ghost direct, and even they tend to just get maybe certain things edited out, and those things sort of happen as well. But since Kangana is a woman, that is why a lot of these people, they are ganging up against her.
See, I don't know who she is talking about, okay? All I know, Faridun, is in my 24 years, if ever anyone has tried to undermine my role as an editor or as a writer, I have stood up to it right then and there. I have not accepted it, and I have even left films because of that. I have every right to do that, and I have done that. I have no grouses. Yes, there are big stars who I've heard stories about. Like, for example, I did a film with Nagesh Kukunur, which starred Akshay Kumar long time ago, called Tasveer, Tasveer 8x10. Right? A very out there concept which did not fly with the Indian public, but still full marks to Nagesh for attempting it. All right? I never once saw Akshay Kumar in the editing room, even though he had a people used to talk about he comes into the edit. Not a single time, right? I have worked with so many different actors, and mainly actors, fewer stars. Like I worked with Manoj Bajpayee, I worked with Rajkumar Rao, I worked with some wonderful actors, including Farooq Sheikh and, even Anil Kapoor, in films. And I have never experienced this before. If you are giving the example of Aamir Khan, which she keeps giving and people keep giving, and if it is true, it is wrong, it should be condemned. But it should be condemned by the people it is happening to. Because you are saying it happened to somebody else, okay, and that person didn't condemn it, इसका मतलब तुम भी मत कंडेम करो, ये गलत बात है, अगर हुआ है तो. I'm not going to, if it happens with me, I'm going to say it. As simple as that. But I still don't know of filmmakers who, of course, a big star, okay, has his territories, has his audience, his or her audience, his or her fan following, okay, and has a certain insight into how that audience will appreciate him or her.
Right.
They have every right to share this insight
right.
with their team, especially while writing the film. So, Kangana's inputs while I was writing the film were completely welcome. There is a time and place, एक कायदा होता है, there is a way that you do it, एक तरीका होता है, right? So there is a way and a time and a place for it. So within that space, please influence the film, influence it correctly. Come into the edit also and suggest, win me over with your argument. That's how collaborations work. You think Hansal and I did not fight on every film we worked on? We had arguments. Manoj and I have had arguments about how a scene should play out and not play out. Anil Kapoor and Anupam Kher had arguments while they were working on films together. I have been party to that. But as collaborators, they saw through it. They didn't say, you're not getting it, main tumko phek deta film ke bahar, tumhara ab mera naam aayega editor, mera naam aayega writer, mera naam aayega director. Ye thodi na hota hai. Ye toh pagalpan hai. And this has to be stopped, or it will set a precedent that will ruin every damn film that comes out in the future.
But Apurva, you are a feminist. You strongly stand for women's rights and equality, and you're a huge champion of that. But looking at it objectively, you've said that it's very difficult for you to be objective. But still, would you agree that certain debates that Kangana has started, be it nepotism and be it equal pay for both male and female actors, there has been certain attempts that have been done by her, which are commendable.
Of course, she should be lauded for all the good things she has done. No person is absolutely bad. No person is born as a villain in this world. People have their issues. People have their screw-ups. They need to overcome them. Need to work on those and not inflict that torture on other people because you haven't worked it out. So, of course, there might be some good things that she has done. I have supported her in her feminist stance before. I have supported her in all the good things that she has believed in.
Right.
But after a point, you start asking this question, are these things truly something you believe in, or are you just trying to get people's affection and their love by saying these things? But when it comes to practice, where is your equality? When you can, okay, you work against nepotism, but what is nepotism? You use your power and influence as a powerful person in the contacts you've made to gain an advantage over somebody who does not have that position. That's nepotism. When you are undermining your writer who's not born into a film family, your editor who's not born into a film family, a director who's not born, who struggled very hard, worked very, very hard. You know, for me to have survived this industry 24 years without a godfather, to have won myself several awards, including a Filmfare Award, a National Award, a State Award, to have love and respect, and to have done films that have reached a place in people's hearts, maybe not the 10 million people, but maybe 100 people who it's touched, and I'm very happy with that. It's taken a lot of hard work. You come in as a big star, and you use your influence with the producers and stuff like that to take out these people and to undermine their effort and to discredit them. That is nepotism. So that means the fight you are fighting out there is a Khokla fight. This is nepotism more than anything else. So no, I don't buy it all. I don't buy all her things anymore. I used to buy it, and I know a lot of people believe in her, and I can see why they're mesmerized by her. But with each film, the truth is coming out, and she's losing a lot of fans.
Okay, so I interviewed Mishti today. So she's played Kashi Bai in Manikarnika. And she told me that she had a lot of scenes. She shot for many days. And Kangana herself requested her to just give more dates, even after though her shooting had been completed. And when she saw the film on 20th January, she said that she's there, but she's hardly having one or two dialogues, and there's absolutely no nothing of her character that has come across. So do you feel that when you're championing the cause of women, you need to be more fair to them?
Of course. I mean, you are not really championing the cause of women when you are actually, your antics and your behavior is anti-feminist. What is your idea of feminism? My idea of feminism is an equal fair playground for men and women. Yeah. Not an advantage that either sex has. Her idea of feminism is that agar tum galtiyan kar rahe ho, toh main bhi wahi galtiyan karunga. I'll not do the right things. I'll see all the things that you have done wrong, all the villainous things you have done wrong, and I will also do them. So log kahenge isne kiya to main kyun nahi kar sakti. This is not feminism. This is pseudo feminism. This is not real. This is only going to compound the problem. It will make men hate women more, and vice versa. It will create the gap, even further gap, and again it will become skewed. I do not believe in that brand of feminism. I don't think it's real. If it were real in her, then this actress you're talking about, I know another actress, her name I think is Swati, who was in the film.
Swati Sengwal.
Yes, yes. I met her recently in another, for another project, and we were talking, you know, and she told me that she had to leave the film because I think her role was either chopped or, you know, she was with Sonu, the role was completely cut out of the film, and, you know, and then she refused to give further dates to shoot it or something like that, you know. And she also was telling me about how much pain and anguish she went through because she had given up so much to be part of the film. And then after that, you know, when you're suddenly left high and dry like that, you know, it creates a major, it shakes at your confidence, you know. So these are women, you know, that she has been unfair to. So that's what I'm trying to say. I mean, I find all these things are very, very shallow. I don't think she truly believes. I think she is crazy about power. I think she's trying to prove a point out there that she can be more powerful than a certain male actor who she has taken a certain, panga or whatever people call it with. And this is her personal business. This is not, everybody does not have to suffer this madness of yours, you know. And film after film after film, she keeps doing it. And a lot of people support her because people love a good fight. And people love to see good, big people go down. It's the way it is. So if somebody is speaking against them, you know, people will support it because it's a fight. It's not real.